There are two primary motions that we will briefly discuss this week, rotation and revolution. Your textbook does a good job summarizing these motions and their impacts, so be sure that you have carefully read the required reading. I'm going to summarize five important points here regarding Earth's rotation on its axis, and then I'm going to note three important impacts of the Earth's rotation. So first, the five important points. First, the Earth rotates from west to east on its axis. This is why it appears as if the sun and the stars at night are rising in the east and setting in the west. The sun and stars are not moving, rather the Earth is rotating to the east. This is also why locations east of us see the sunrise before we do. Study the figure here. Second, one rotation on the Earth's axis is 24 hours. You knew that. It takes one day for the Earth to rotate once on its axis. And at any given time, half of the Earth is within the circle of illumination, meaning half of the Earth is in the sunlight and half of the Earth is in the darkness. Third, notice the axial tilt. The Earth's axis of rotation is not perpendicular to the plane on which the Earth revolves around the Sun, which we call the plane of the ecliptic. Rather, the Earth's axis is tilted 23.5 degrees from perpendicular. 23.5 degrees. That number should sound familiar. The previous figure was from an earlier edition of the textbook, but I thought it showed the tilt very well. This is the same figure from this edition of the textbook. Again, notice the Earth's axis is tilted 23.5 degrees. Fourth, notice the polarity of the Earth's axis. By polarity, we note that the Earth's axis is always pointing at the same direction. Not only is it tilted at 23.5 degrees, but it is also always pointed in the same location out into outer space. Coincidentally, if you go out from the North Pole out into space, the Earth's axis points pretty much right at what we call the North Star. Lastly, our fifth point regarding the rotation of the Earth on its axis is that the speed of rotation varies by latitude. This is interesting. The Earth is rotating at different speeds depending on the location you are on Earth or the latitude you are on Earth. That's probably something you've never considered before. The Earth is rotating much faster near the equator than it is as you move towards the poles. This may make more sense if we look at the Earth. We know that it takes 24 hours for the Earth to make one rotation. Along the equator, that's a great distance. If you put a piece of string around a globe at the equator, it'd be a long piece of string. The Earth has to go a great distance at the equator in 24 hours. If we consider up at the Arctic Circle, the Earth doesn't have to go as far in 24 hours. The circumference up there, or the path along the Arctic Circle, is much shorter. So it's going much slower in 24 hours to complete that circle. So again, strange but true, the speed of rotation on Earth varies by latitude. It's fastest at the equator and slower as you approach the poles. Now that we have a good understanding of the rotation of the Earth, we can see how the rotation of the Earth on its axis impacts the Earth system. There's three primary effects that we're going to briefly mention here. First of all, the obvious one, the passage of day and night. As the Earth rotates, different parts of Earth rotate past the Sun. Basically, different parts of the Earth are within the circle of illumination. Notably, as noted earlier, at any given time, half of the Earth is within the circle of illumination. We'll talk about the related concepts of day length and the passage of time and time zones in subsequent videos. The second impact related to rotation is the tides. As the Earth turns, points of the waters on the Earth's surface experience increasing and decreasing gravitational pull due to the changing distance from the Sun and the Moon. Tides move in and out as a result of this increasing and decreasing gravitational pull. The third effect is something called the Coriolis effect, and we're going to deal with this in more detail a little bit later in the course. But the Coriolis effect is an apparent deflection of free-moving fluids to the right in the northern hemisphere and to the left in the southern hemisphere. This is what's responsible for the circular rotation of hurricanes and storm systems, among other things. Again, we'll study this later in the course. For now, though, maybe just understand what we mean by the Coriolis effect. It's an apparent deflection of free-moving fluids to the right in the northern hemisphere and to the left in the southern hemisphere. And it's due to the varying speeds of different latitudes as the Earth rotates.